Have you ever heard of an octopus whose venom can kill a person in just a few minutes? No. What about poisonous frogs that can kill over 20,000 mice with just a drop of their toxin? Still no. Then it's time you heard about them. In this video, I'll tell you about the most amazing venomous animals, from king snakes to box jellyfish. Make sure to watch the video until the end, as the most unusual venomous creature you've ever seen awaits you. Enjoy watching. Blue-ringed octopus. I would like to start my story with the blue-ringed octopus. For much of its life, this seemingly harmless creature hides in shelters. But it's best not to disturb it. If you do, you'll be in for quite a rough time. The blue-ringed octopus is one of the most venomous creatures on the planet. Its venom can paralyze the respiratory muscles, leading to death by asphyxiation within just 2 minutes of being bitten. This octopus instills fear in everyone. Children swimming in the sea, divers, beach volleyball players, and even biologists who undertake risky expeditions to study these cephalopods and their neurotoxins. The blue-ringed octopus gets its name from the characteristic rings on its body. There are about 60 of them, and when irritated, they become brighter, and dark brown spots appear on its yellow skin, signaling aggression and warning the intruder of danger. If you ignore these warnings and continue to bother the poor creature, it will start to bite, as its saliva is venomous. It contains tetrodotoxin. Moreover, the bite is completely painless for humans. You won't even realize you only have a few minutes left to live. Quite sad, isn't it? But that's not all. The venom paralyzes the body, including the entire respiratory system. However, the victim remains conscious and cannot do anything about it. Just imagine, you can't even ask those around you for help because you can't speak, and most people are unlikely to know how to help you. You wouldn't wish such a fate on even your worst enemy. But let's not dwell on the sad. The venom doesn't kill the person, so if artificial respiration is administered until medics arrive and the victim is connected to a ventilator, the venom will cease its effect in a few hours, and everyone will be saved. Use this life hack. Poison dart frogs. Next on our list is another remarkable inhabitant of Central and South America. Poison dart frogs are the most poisonous amphibians on our planet. Their toxin is so potent that just one drop would be enough to kill more than 20,000 mice. Yet, the frogs themselves are completely immune to their own poison, and scientists worldwide still haven't unraveled the secret of their invulnerability. Quite scary, isn't it? Hopefully, our world won't be taken over by frogs anytime soon. Poison dart frogs got their name thanks to the indigenous people of the Chaco region in Colombia, who use their venom for hunting monkeys and other game. The Embera tribe hunters catch small golden frogs, rub their darts against their backs, and then load the poisonous darts into their blowpipes. With such deadly weapons, they can kill monkeys, birds, and even jaguars. Scientists have discovered that one such frog can kill more than 20 adult men. Therefore, the natives must be cautious when collecting their tiny hunting partners. Despite their apparent danger, these little creatures may soon benefit our lives. How is that possible? Let me explain. The scientific community is intrigued by the complex substances produced by poison dart frogs. These potent nitrogen-containing compounds, known as batrachotoxins, prevent nerve impulse transmission. One drop of this neurotoxin can stop a heart. The ability to suppress nerve impulses could lead to the development of new medications to help patients experiencing severe pain. Epibatidine, extracted from the frog's skin, blocks pain much more effectively than morphine and does not cause addiction. These brightly colored creatures are not fierce predators. They use their venom solely for defense and never attack first. Many people even enjoy keeping poisonous frogs as pets. It's not dangerous because amphibians gradually lose their toxicity if their diet is changed, and frogs hatched in captivity never become poisonous. Box jellyfish. Now I'll tell you about the most venomous creature on our planet. And no, it's not a snake or a spider. It's the box jellyfish. In the past 50 years, this beauty has taken the lives of more than 6,000 people, and the chances of survival after a sting are zero. However, some have managed to survive an encounter with this cubic monster. How? I'll explain now. As you might guess, these jellyfish get their name from their body shape, not because they played Minecraft, although the second option seemed plausible to me too. Their tentacles, like other jellyfish, are covered with stinging cells called nematocysts, which contain venom. Each tentacle has more than 5,000 such cells, but they don't activate just by touch. It's the chemical reaction with the outer layers of the victim that triggers their activation. Among all jellyfish, box jellyfish are considered the most advanced. Unlike their relatives, they don't just drift passively in the water, but can actively move. Moreover, they have eyes similar to human eyes. However, box jellyfish lack a central nervous system, and scientists still don't understand how they process visual information. The most venomous box jellyfish are the sea wasp and the irukandji jellyfish. Their toxins are hundreds of times more potent than cobra venom. An adult irukandji, about the size of your index finger, resembles a small transparent bell with four long, thin, and almost invisible tentacles. Its venom causes paralytic effects and heart failure within minutes. But you probably won't live long enough to experience that, as you'll most likely die from shock immediately after the sting. But how can you survive? Actually, it's relatively simple. You need to smear the sting site with vinegar. But where you'll get vinegar in the sea is unclear. Nonetheless, survivors of attacks often suffer from pain for months and have scars where the tentacles touch them. King Cobra. Now, let me tell you about the most popular venomous creature. As you might have guessed, it's the queen of venomous snakes, the king cobra. These snakes live up to 30 years and can reach 12 feet in length. Unlike our previous venomous friends, cobras are true predators. They can raise a third of their body length to spot prey. Their very sharp vision helps them in this. They can see prey up to 300 feet away, and if that's not enough, their forked tongue, which detects the faintest smells, comes to the rescue. Yes, it actually smells with its tongue amazing. The snake also senses ground vibrations, helping it assess the location and movement of its surroundings. Despite their intimidating appearance and deadly venom, king cobras are not the most dangerous snakes to humans. They rarely use their venom against people, saving it for hunting, as their favorite delicacy is other cobras, and humans are of no interest as food. If they bite someone, it is often without injecting venom, just to scare and drive them away. However, if a king cobra decides to use its formidable weapon, the consequences can be fatal. Its venom contains a powerful neurotoxin, causing excruciating pain and then paralysis. Upon venom injection, the chances of survival are minimal, and death can occur within half an hour. Anti-venom must be administered immediately. In Thailand, a turmeric decoction is also used as a folk remedy, taken before a bite to reduce the effect of the venom. This helps prevent paralysis. Unfortunately, the population of king cobras is rapidly declining due to human destruction of their natural habitat. It's a good thing these snakes don't realize that their greatest enemy is humans. Leiurus Scorpion. How can we talk about the most poisonous animals without mentioning a scorpion whose sting can make you lose your memory? Let me introduce you to the Leiurus Scorpion. At first glance, it might seem harmless. Small, with yellow sticks for legs, almost resembling a cutlet. But don't let appearances deceive you. Approaching it is dangerous. Leiurus, or the yellow fat-tailed scorpion, is not only a formidable defender in the scorpion kingdom, but also a fierce adversary for humans. Its venom is one of the most potent and fast-acting, especially for humans. Almost immediately after being stung, the victim can experience severe pain, swelling, redness, fever, sweating, nausea, and vomiting. Fortunately, they are not aggressive toward humans unless provoked. This translucent predator mainly inhabits Africa, but populations are also found in Australia, Argentina, and other Latin American countries. There have been several cases in the Centra, Isito African Republic, where a Leiurus sting caused a person to completely lose their memory of who they are. Doctors attribute this to an apoplectic shock induced by the scorpion's venom, leading to amnesia. Such cases are rare and not fully understood. Amazingly, these deadly creatures only reach about 4 inches in length and live for just a few years. Generally, the smaller the scorpion, the more dangerous its sting. Indiana Jones said it best. The smaller the scorpion, the more potent its venom. Researchers at the National University of Ireland analyzed the venom of more than 30 scorpion species and found that the smallest ones had venom hundreds of times more potent than the largest ones. This scorpion commands respect and caution. If you are an adventurous tourist who loves exploring exotic corners of the world, be prepared to encounter this dangerous creature. You might be lucky and never meet one, but it's always better to be on guard. Brazilian wandering spider. And of course, what list would be complete without spiders? In 2010, the Guinness World Records recognized the Brazilian wandering spider as the most venomous in the world. The Greek name for these arachnids translates to murderer, a fitting name since they are considered among the most poisonous spiders on the planet. Their bites contain neurotoxic venom that is lethal to humans. These hairy creatures are dangerous not only because of their venom, but also because of their behavior. They don't spin webs or stay in one place, but actively roam the ground. They can hide in buildings, clothes, shoes, and cars, increasing the risk of an unexpected encounter and bite. They spend most of the day hiding under logs or in cracks and come out at night to hunt, feeding on insects, other spiders, and occasionally small amphibians, reptiles, and mice. Because of their toxicity and characteristic threat posture, these spiders have gained a reputation for being aggressive. However, their behavior is actually a defensive mechanism. When threatened, they raise their front legs to warn potential predators of their venomous nature and readiness to attack. Interestingly, a bite from a Brazilian wandering spider can cause a prolonged, painful erection in men due to an increase in nitric oxide levels, a chemical that increases blood flow. This unusual symptom has been studied for developing drugs to treat erectile dysfunction. Despite their venomous nature, these spiders rarely inject venom or do so in minimal amounts, as producing venom requires significant resources. Therefore, fatal cases from Brazilian wandering spider bites are extremely rare. That's some relief. The most dangerous snail. And now for the moment you've been waiting for, the most unusual yet dangerous poisonous creature on our planet, cone snails, also known as cigarette snails, because their appearance indeed resembles a cigarette. Today, I will tell you about these unusual creatures. Despite their seemingly harmless appearance, these snails pose a significant danger to shell collectors. Their looks can be deceiving. When picked up, cone snails defend themselves by releasing harpoons. Bites from larger species can be fatal to humans, and the bite of a cigarette snail leaves virtually no chance of survival. Interestingly, there is no known antidote for their venom, making them the most dangerous poisonous creatures. Cone snails mainly feed on marine worms, although some species prefer mollusks and fish. The venom of species that hunt fish can cause paralysis within seconds. Imagine that. 1 second, and the prey is already incapacitated. You might think that snails are naturally slow. Generally, that's true. But at night, cone snails become true predators, fast and agile. Their weapon, a harpoon with toxic secretions, shoots out instantly, paralyzing the prey. The snail then slowly retracts the victim and digests it whole, replacing the used tooth with a new one. The only way to survive a bite is to make an immediate incision and bleed the wound to remove the venom. There is no other effective method yet. However, cone snail venom is already being used in non-opioid painkillers. One component of the venom is used in anti-wrinkle creams, causing localized inflammation that smooths the skin. Research on the venom of predatory cone snails has led to the development of a miniature version of insulin that works faster than human insulin. This could be the basis for new drugs to ease the lives of diabetes patients. So, the cone snail is both beautiful and deadly. Remember, knowledge is your best ally in the wild. Stay vigilant and cautious, and may your adventures be safe and thrilling. But knowledge can also help in another way, correct? It can help you earn money. So if you want to make a decent income, I have a suggestion for you. We're looking for scriptwriters, narrators, editors, and creative producers for our videos. Interested? Then follow the link in the description and apply. Thank you for watching.